We recently celebrated the 250th birthday of the genius German composer Ludwig van Beethoven, who called himself as a tone poet instead of composer. He stated the reason as he could convey a message through music without a story. His piano concerto in question was composed in 1811. He dedicated the work to Archduke Rudolf, one of his main supporters at that time. The work got a name such as Imperial Concerto because of its extended size. Its duration is unusually extended, has an important ideological message with great energy, he reasoned, requesting high technical skills for the performer. On these all listed reasons can be described as an example of the Beethovenian musical revolution. The piece begins with a chord for the O. Then, immediately a cadenza follows on the piano, that used to appear at the end of similar composed concerti before. Movement of the work consists of five scale divisions, including one on a double exposition form. The orchestra and the piano do a kind of fight, a duel that shortly concludes in a balanced dialogue between each other. In the second part, they both go to a direction, to a location where there is no time and space, a spiritual world where only the human soul exists. Thank you. where the preparation for the third section of the work, where time seems to stop to exist, the third movement suddenly burns out in a lively dancing characteristic. The music concludes in a triumphant conclusion, representing Beethoven as a real Tom Poet. Beethoven conveys a large scale of human emotions representing love, friendship, joy, trust and anger as well. His music understood by millions of people as an invitation for peace offering hope. He suggests us we are one creation, all brothers and sisters sharing the same feelings listed above. With this statement on the Beethovenian music, one can hear directly God talking to us. We are all very grateful to him and his creation, his message for the entire human race. Thank you very much, Beethoven, and happy birthday.